Hey everybody, Steven here, and this is just going to be a quick video on a neck and trap stretch that I do with clients and with myself here. I've done a video series previously, and I'm going to start this with this particular stretch. I'm going to link to that other video series at the end of this video, and then in the description, so it'll be in the notes for this. I'm actually going to do this, and I'm going to do it as segments for each different stretch or soft tissue drill that I do, just because so many people have like a forward head leaning posture where they're here, they can't quite pull that back. I see a lot of that, and then this really has to do with we're on our phones a lot, or we're sitting at a computer or a desk or whatever it is, and our head is actually pulled forward like this. As this all gets stretched out, this becomes really, really tight and tries to lock that down. So for this, all you're gonna need is like a 15 or 20 pound dumbbell. I have this right here. And what we do with this is once I'm here, I wanna make sure that my shoulders are set so I'm not letting this like pull me or drop my shoulder out. I'm here, I'm set. And then once I'm here, I'm essentially gonna keep my head locked in this position and I'm going to tilt my head this way, right? So this is locked, I tilt my head this way. I'll feel that stretch along my scalenes here. Might feel a little bit in the SEM and it goes across that trap. When you're really, really tight, because all of this is interconnected, you'll actually feel this go down your bicep also. So I'm gonna tilt that way. And then I'm gonna bring my chin, I'm gonna hold about maybe 5 to 10 seconds. I'm gonna bring my chin down to this pocket, like this. I'll hold that there. I'll come back up, and then when I tilt this way again, I'm gonna take my chin and I'm gonna bring it up at this angle this way. You can feel that right down through here. And then I'm gonna take my tongue and I'm gonna push it up against the roof of my mouth because that's a muscle also and it's gonna help stretch right through here. So as I tilt this way and back, really pushing that tongue up, and then I'll come back. Now with this, the orientation of this weight is here, right? So it's at my side like I might just hold two dumbbells. I'm actually going to then do the same drill, but I'm gonna turn my palm this way, right? So I'm gonna take that, keep my head straight, turn this way, then I'll take that chin, I'll pocket it. I'm gonna bring it back up, I'll come to the side, and then pull back this way. Pushing that tongue against the roof of the mouth. For this, you might feel a little bit more. I usually feel it more in my trap, and it just feels like a deeper stretch to me, changing my palm like this. You might feel the other one different. You might feel that one more, the first one that we did. But we do that variation, so I literally do palm at my side, and then I rotate so my palm is facing away from me for either one of those. So, this is gonna be the first video. I'm gonna do, I don't know how many, there's a whole bunch of different stuff that I do now for this that stacks on what I did with that initial four-part series. So we're gonna include some of those, but we're gonna expand upon them a little bit with some of the new stretches, soft tissue work, or variations of stuff that I've done before with that. So, thank you guys so much for watching. If there's anything that you're struggling with, if you have questions on anything, there's something else that you wanna see, you're like, hey, I really like the neck stuff, but I wanna see shoulders or quad, whatever it is, right? Let me know with that and I'll make sure that I get that video out for you. If I don't know how to do it, I'm gonna spend time doing research before I just pump out content that might not help you, okay? So thank you guys so much for watching and look for that second video where we're gonna cover actually some band stretches that are gonna help with that, getting up into that trap. A lot of people have trouble stretching the trap, right? It might stretch the neck and a little bit of the trap, but isolating that stretch on the trap, running down into the rhomboids is usually difficult, so that's what we're gonna do for part 2.